Hello coders, today's topic is a very regular topic of Spring Boot application or Spring application, loose coupling. You might have seen, if you are already into the Spring development, you might have seen auto add, that is what dependency injection that we do use in more or less every program or every bit of code which you use in Spring development, but sometime we never know about it, what is it all about. So let us discuss this regular topic also. So loose coupling, if you look at the other side of the coin, that is tightly coupled, we must not go for tightly coupled thing in any type of development. It might be in Spring, it might be in somewhere else. Tightly coupled means if one object is completely dependent upon other object, we cannot separate it. And we define the coupling at the time of writing the code by using the new keyword, by using the constructor. But in loose coupling, we don't go for using this new keyword constructor for creating an object of a class inside another class. So obviously there is going to be isolation of code from one class to another class. So one class is going to be independent of the second class. So here I have given a simple example of a computer and a table. In a real life example, if you look at a computer can be a laptop, can be a desktop, a table can be a steel or a wooden table. But while we use together, the table doesn't know which computer is going to be there over it. Computer also doesn't know which table it is going to be on it. So that is what at the time of execution, I mean, suppose we are discussing now we are having an object of computer, that is what a laptop, and as well as an object of a table, that is what a wooden table, you can say. But tomorrow I may change the table while I am executing it, I may change the laptop to desktop also. So that is what is the loose coupling. It is easy to test, means if something goes wrong with this laptop, I know I don't need to break my table to test it. I need to test the computer. If something goes wrong with this table, again I don't need to test the computer or the laptop. So that is what, no, there is no testability. The testing or the tester's life is going to be easier if you go for loose coupling. And obviously most important thing, change. So this requirement always going to come in agile development. We always be ready for the change request. If the change request comes, then what will happen if you don't go for loose coupling? You have to write the code from top to bottom or bottom to top. So that is a very awkward situation we will be into. That is what rework will be there entirely from zero. If you go for loose coupling in Spring Boot, we can define different classes which are independent of each other. It is very important term, dependency injection is not only being asked in the interviews, but also we use in our day-to-day basis development. And as well as the Spring container decides which object is going to be injected in which another object. We don't decide at the time of writing the code. That can be done with the help of the most important keyword in Spring development, that is what is auto add. That is what, for the dependency injection we do it. We can go for dependency injection with the help of constructor, with the help of setter methods, but most easier one is auto add. And this component is a keyword also we can use, that is again is a modern day of using Spring. Previously we were using XML for defining the bin. You might have remembered, if you are a seasoned Spring developer, you might have used bin.xml, which is no more used in Spring 5 or Spring Boot 2.3. and this is a very old way of using controller. Controller you can use, you can go for using REST controller to have a demonstration of dependency injection or this loose coupling. So let us have a look at the code, a very simple code a real life code we will use in Spring Boot by using STS. So let us go for the development of a project. Here I am into our favorite Spring development IDE, that's STS. To save our time, I have already created a Spring Boot application. This is only a template, Spring Boot web application. In fact, I have included this pom.xml, or in fact I have included a web into this pom.xml. So nothing special over here. If you have not seen how to create a Spring Boot application in STS, you can refer to the link which I will put in the description box. So let us go for using this dependency injection with the help of the Spring Boot application. So first we will go for creating an interface. So in the root package, I will go for creating an interface. So new, so package name I'll add, suppose com.example.office. I'll use repo, so here the repo or interface name is printer. Suppose you can give anything, but in dependency injection we go for injection with the help of an interface. So I gave the name as printer, so it is an ordinary interface itself. So I'll put a method over here so that the subclass of this interface can go for using those method. So I'll only one method I will put. We know that an a printer can print, so that's what we can have a method inside this printer interface. Now I will go for creating a component which will use this interface as the super interface. Again, right click on the root package, create a class, go for naming the package com.example.office. I'll use components as the components. Okay, so I'll go for using, suppose HP printer is the class name I'll use. As you know, there is a company or a brand exists as HP. What I will do, I will create a HP will be the sub interface, a subclass of printer. So we need to override the print method. So here in this print method, I'll return a piece of string, something regarding this HP tagline. I have already copied from the HP website. I'll put over here. This is going to return value of this print method, which is there inside this print. But this class is not an ordinary class, and as well as we are not going to use any XML definition. We will go for using the annotation as component. One thing I have to mention over here, if you have not gone through my video which is there for the annotation, I will put the link regarding annotation in Spring Boot or maybe in Java. That link you can follow to know about the annotations. So here I have declared this HP printer class as a component. That's all about this class. Then finally we will go for creating a controller. So controller, again right click on the base package, create a class, then name it as something, but the package name has to be it can be anything, but we should keep it as a package separately than your base package. I named it as controllers. Suppose the class name I will make it as print controller. Okay, then this is going to be not a ordinary class, it is going to be a REST controller. Yeah, so here it is going to be a REST controller. Then inside it, I'll go for using a request param, so that we can go for a request mapping. In fact, we will go for accessing this method which you are going to define with the help of an URI. Suppose print service, I will name it as the
request mapping, then I will define any method. Public string is going to be the return value, is going to be named as, suppose, anything, print me. And here, this is what is the point. Here we are going to go for dependency injection with the help of AutoAdd. So the annotation is going to be AutoAdd. Which one we are going to inject over here? We are going to inject HP printer. Sorry, we are not going to use HP printer directly. We will be using the interface. The interface is going to be printer. This name as printer, the reference. Then we know printer has a method as print, which will return a piece of string. We can store it into a string type of variable, suppose string data, then we will return it. That's all. Return, then the data. So here, this is how you have gone for injection of printer into the print controller class, but we have not gone for mentioning anything regarding HP printer. As I told you, we can go for using computer, but we don't know which computer will be there at the time of execution. So whichever printers in printers subclass is going to be there, that is going to be used over here. You might be having the question, if there will be multiple subclasses, then what will happen? That is going to give us exception at the runtime. But now we don't need to think about it. So not unique exception will be there, but now it should run. If I'll execute it as a Spring Boot application, then we should get this print service is going to be the endpoint of our REST controller. We will go to the web browser, suppose localhost 8080. If we'll use only localhost colon 8080, we should get 404. Yes, but we have a separate, localhost 8080 print service. You can see we got the output as make it matter, keep reinventing, which is the line from HP printer class. So this is a very simple example of dependency injection. The next video we will discuss about non-unique dependency injection by using qualifier. So thanks for watching.